Yes, April, and many people are offering prayers during this time of transition. Now, Holley had only been bishop since 2016, but it seems that his management may have led to this decision. Nearly 2 years after Bishop Martin Holley was greeted at the Catholic Diocese of Memphis.
I come to the diocese with a great joy.
Pope Francis removed him. The announcement came from the Vatican Wednesday morning. The phrasing in the announcement is commonly used by the Vatican when a bishop refuses to resign voluntarily. A Vatican spokesperson cited management issues and not abuse related. The Catholic Diocese of Memphis stated there were several efforts to restore peace and serenity, and they asked for prayers for the diocese and for Bishop Holley as he departs from Memphis.
It sounds like it's a political, you know, kind of office politics type of stuff.
Many are taking their best guesses. In June, the Vatican launched an investigation after Holley had reassigned many of the priests across the 21 West Tennessee counties. The results of that investigation haven't been made public.
Relationships are everything in this world. You know, you have to get along with your peers.
What is clear? Who's taking over in the meantime?
I'm Archbishop Joseph Kurtz of the Archdiocese of Louisville.
The Vatican appointed Louisville Archbishop Joseph Kurtz. He will oversee the diocese until further notice. In a statement in part, he promised stability, peace, and healing until Pope Francis appoints a new bishop. I've admired the church in Memphis for many years, particularly from my time as Bishop of Knoxville. And that statement went on to say that he also offers his prayers to Bishop Holley and to the Church of Memphis. Of course, we're going to continue to work our sources and find out more information and let you know as this story unfolds. Live in downtown Memphis, Jessica Gertler, WREG, News Channel 3.